morning, Eisenhower. I'm your host, Ryan, along with...
Ian.
Today is Wednesday, March 6th, 2013.
It's a day A.
Today in history. On March 6th, 1981, after 19 years of presenting the CBS Evening News, Walter Cronkite signs off for the last time.
This month's chain link challenge is Manners March. We want to encourage all students this month to practice good manners. Students should say please and thank you, open doors for others, share, raise their hand to speak in class, not cut the lunch line, and just display good manners all month. Take the challenge and make a difference. Let's make Eisenhower a feel-good, better place this March. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated.
And now for today's announcements with
Kat
and Alana.
Good morning, I'm Kat, along with
Alana.
What does today's weather look like?
Today, windy with a few rain or snow showers developing this afternoon, high near 40. Tonight, rain and snow this evening, becoming snow overnight to 30 miles per hour, 3 to 5 inches of snow expected. Tomorrow, snow showers in the morning will give way to a mixture of rain and snow for the afternoon, high 39. Now here's Kat with today's announcements.
Thanks, Alana. The last 8th grade canteen is Friday, March 8th at 7:30 to 9:30. Doors open at 7:20. No early admittance is permitted. You have a DJ, a guitar hero, and games. So socialize with friends, dance, and have fun. Please bring in a non-perishable canned or boxed good to be donated to the local charity. A raffle ticket will be given for each item donated. There will be 3 gift cards raffled off. Attention all Eisenhower boys basketball players. Please return your clean uniform to Mr. Finale in room 202. Reminder to all track and field athletes. Please drop off your forms to the nurse as soon as possible and don't forget to fill out the online survey. Attention all students interested in participating in the amazing race next Friday, March 15th. Please hand in the yellow team forms to Ms. Caputo and Ms. Parada. Teams may consist of 4 to 6 students. All team forms are due by next Tuesday. Permission slips and donations may be handed in at that time or at the door. Thanks. There will be a Brain Busters meeting in room 517 after school today. The TV Lab color printer is out of ink. Please do not print to the TV Lab color printer. Ink is expected to arrive by the end of the day. The new garden club will meet Tuesdays and Thursdays to take care of the Peace Garden and Community Garden. Members may attend one or both days. We need to prepare the gardens now and plant them in April and May. See Ms. Mack or Ms. Chen for more information. Keep calm and garden on. There will be a Battle of the Books Club meeting this Thursday, March 7th in room 508. It will end at 4 o'clock. Here's Alana with the rest of today's announcements.
Thank you, Kat. While all the debate club members meet during homeroom in front of Ms. Katradman's room, it is important that the debate club members from the fall club cycle show up. From Ms. Sloan. Advisory will meet today. The next advisory will be on March 27th. There will be a meeting for all students interested in playing baseball or softball today, March 6th, after school. The baseball meeting will be in Mr. DeBlock's room, and the softball meeting will be in Ms. Laverty's room. Both meetings will go until 3:15. Please see Mr. Pichotto and Ms. Laverty if you cannot attend. All students who wish to try out for baseball, softball, or track must have their medical form submitted to the nurse no later than March 13, 3 p.m. The Wyckoff Library Teen Writers Group will be meeting this Thursday in the Monroe Room from 6 o'clock to 7:30. Teens or tweens from 6th to 10th grade who have an interest in writing are welcome to join this dynamic and growing group. If you plan to attend, contact Barbara, the teen librarian, as soon as possible to register. Bring a piece of writing that you have done, prose, poetry, or nonfiction, and be prepared to read it to the group. Please let your like-minded friends know, too, because all budding writers are welcome. Snacks will be available at this meeting. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Caitlin and A.L. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is fish sandwich with fries and coleslaw. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is penne with meatballs. What's in the headlines?
President Hugo Chavez of Venezuela died Tuesday afternoon after a struggle with cancer. And now for today's feature with Melissa
and Jacob.
Have you ever done Create a Game in gym?
No, but it looks fun. Let's check out this feature on Create a Game.
Mike and Mike.
This year in Eisenhower, the 8th grade gym classes have the opportunity to create their own game. In Create Your Own Game, you can use any components from any sports, and you can use any of the gym equipment. My Create a Game has the components of hockey, soccer, basketball, and handball. Let's go see what Eisenhower thinks of Create a Game. I'm here with Ms. Federici talking about Create a Game. So Ms. Federici, how did Create a Game come about?
Create a Game came about with very creative students who really wanted to showcase some of their ideas and what they were passionate about to create their ultimate game.
What were the best games that your students made?
Some of the best games had the simplest rules so that everybody understood them. They had very simple equipment and were very concise. That's why the games of tag, for instance, always survived, because they had really simple rules. So if they just put a slight twist on the game, then they made their own new game. And the kids really enjoyed that.
Thanks for being with us.
Sure.
So Nick, what was your creative game?
It was called Capture the Balls.
What'd you do in it?
It was pretty much like Capture the Flag, but you had to capture beach balls, and you could only punch them. You couldn't carry them. So,
what equipment did you use besides beach balls?
We only used cones besides beach balls. So,
what components of sports did you use?
Cardio. That's pretty much it. Like, we just ran around a lot.
Nice.
Yeah.
I'm here with Joe and Leith talking about Create a Game. So, Joe, what was your game about?
My game was Race Cards instead of Race Cars, and it's a relay game where you choose a card with a random exercise on it, and you have to do that exercise to get further distance, and whoever gets across wins.
Intriguing. And you, Leith?
Well, my game is more like a Capture the Flag kind of game. So basically, each team has, like, pool noodles, and everyone gets a pool noodle. So to play it, you had to capture the other person's flag, which is a bowling pin, but you had to whack the person with the pool noodle to get them out.
Very nice.
Interviewer Mike, camera Mike, editing Mike, and Mike.
Create a Game looks really fun.
Yeah, and now back to our hosts, Ian.
Ryan.
Thanks, Jacob and Melissa.
Thanks for watching. Have a bummer in the summer Wednesday.